In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, give us the grace of an attentive love to celebrate these days of joy, devoted to the honour of the risen Lord, and teach us to hold fast in all we do to the truths we recall in these sacred mysteries. We ask you this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Philip went down to a city of Samaria and proclaimed to them the Christ, and the multitudes with one accord gave heed to what was said by Philip, when they heard him and saw the signs which he did. For unclean spirits came out of many who were possessed, crying with a loud voice, and many who were paralyzed or lame were healed. So there was much joy in that city. Now when the apostles at Jerusalem heard that Samaria had received the word of God, they sent to them Peter and John, who came down and prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Spirit, for it had not yet fallen on any of them, but they had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then they laid their hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Cry out with joy to God, all the earth.
Cry out with joy to God, all the earth.
Cry out with joy to God, all the earth. O sing to the glory of his name. O render him glorious praise. Say to God, how tremendous your deeds.
Cry out with joy to God, all the earth.
Before you all the earth shall bow, shall sing to you, sing to your name. Come and see the works of God, tremendous his deeds among men.
Cry out with joy to God, all the earth.
He turned the sea into dry land, they passed through the river dry shod. Let our joy then be in him, he rules forever by his might.
Cry out with joy to God, all the earth.
Come and hear all who fear the Lord. I will tell what he did for my soul. Blessed be God, who did not reject my prayer, nor withhold his love from me.
Cry out with joy to God, all the earth.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. In your hearts, reverence Christ as Lord. Always be prepared to make a defence to anyone who calls you to account for the hope that is in you. Yet do it with gentleness and reverence. And keep your conscience clear, so that when you are abused, those who revile your good behaviour in Christ may be put to shame. For it is better to suffer for doing right, if that should be God's will, than for doing wrong. For Christ also died for sins once for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, that he might bring us to God, being put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the Spirit. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. Jesus said, if anyone loves me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we shall come to him. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will pray the Father, and he will give you another counselor to be with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he dwells within you and will be in you. I will not leave you desolate. I will come to you. Yet a little while and the world will see me no more, but you will see me. Because I live, you will live also. In that day you will know that I am in the Father, and you in me, and I in you. He who has my commandments and keeps them, he it is who loves me. And he who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and manifest myself to him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The words of the Gospel. The author of John's Gospel is often referred to as the mystical evangelist. And from this passage and others in the same chapter, you can see why. The emphasis that John places not only on the personal, but the intimate nature of Jesus' relationship with his followers is without parallel in the other Gospels. John makes it plain that it's not a relationship of slavish imitation or dutiful obedience, but mutual presence and intimate indwelling, surpassing the power of words to express. Hence John's many and varied images, the branch and the vine, for instance. And that same felt failure of words to express the ineffable is present in the writings of all the great mystics, who in the struggle to convey an inkling of their experience, frequently forsake prose for poetry. Think of the sublime and often overtly erotic poetry of the 16th century Spanish mystics St. Teresa of Avila and St. John of the Cross. But long before the 16th century, many of the early church fathers also freely used language of human love and desire to express how God draws us to himself. St. Gregory the Great's writings, for instance, are filled with wonderfully earthy images, voicing our desire for God and his for us. A lover asking for yet another kiss. A person of a sweet tooth longing for more of the same. The dizziness experienced at the edge of a precipice. He says, "All those in whom the desire for God is deeply embedded never cease yearning for more. Every delight in God becomes kindling for still more ardent desire. We are led to God by desire, drawn to him as if pulled by a rope." And whereas we are all accustomed to speaking and hearing of God's goodness and truth, they spoke also of his beauty, the cause of our desire and attraction. The incomparable St. Augustine, for instance, who from personal experience knew more than most the power of physical attraction, gives exquisite expression to his sense of God's sublime, ineffable beauty, irresistibly attracting and overwhelming us, inviting us into that personal relationship with him for which we've been made and without which, as he so memorably says, our hearts remain forever restless. "Your word struck my heart, Lord, and from that moment I loved you," he says. And lamenting his failure to see the beauty of God that was ever before his eyes, he utters his famous words, "Late have I loved thee, O beauty, so ancient and so new. Late have I loved thee." And in a wonderful sermon on Psalm 45, Augustine relates Christ's story solely in terms of beauty. Christ, he says, is beautiful in heaven, beautiful on earth, beautiful in the womb, beautiful in his mother's arms, beautiful in his miracles, beautiful under the scourge, beautiful when inviting to life, beautiful when laying down his own life, beautiful in taking it up again, beautiful on the cross, beautiful in the tomb, beautiful in heaven. So these great Christian thinkers didn't doubt for a second that God's way of attracting us, of captivating us, is through our natural desire for beauty. Not the beauty of false compare, of course, but the beauty that engages our whole selves, hearts and minds, as well as senses. But importantly, also our senses, which according to Aquinas, God has given us so that we might delight in him through his creation. Our deepest felt desire, again according to Aquinas, can be satisfied, however, only by divine love, which is the source and goal of all love. So what could be more natural than that we should see in God's beauty, goodness, and truth what we desire most? In this life, of course, desire is never perfectly satisfied, because we possess nothing perfectly in this world. Indeed, we possess nothing at all in any real sense, not even our lives. But though desire is forever restless, love is peace. And what is sought in desire is possessed only in perfect love, which of its nature never ends. So what John's Gospel and the Fathers of the Church open our minds to then is the great mystery of the heart, not only of the Christian life, but of creation itself. Namely, that in Christ, through that desire for and attraction to beauty that so deeply shapes our nature, God draws us into his own life, so that Christ becomes the light by which we see and the love by which we live. Clement of Alexandria couldn't be more explicit. Our Saviour is beautiful and is loved by those who desire true beauty. But the mystery is even deeper. Nothing brings us into more immediate contact with Christ's beauty than our fellow human beings, those around us at this moment. We need look no further. In Gerard Manley Hopkins's words, the just man acts in God's eye what in God's eye he is, Christ. For Christ plays in 10,000 places, lovely in limbs and lovely in eyes, not his, to the Father through the features of men's faces. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us bring before God our Father all our needs.
Let us pray for grace to be instruments of peace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for grace to acknowledge God's gifts. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for grace to share generously what we ourselves have been given. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for grace to be fearless before injustice and courageous in difficulty. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for grace to make wise choices, to persevere in our commitments, and for humility to acknowledge our needs. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for our college, for its mission and its members, past and present. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for the sick and the dying, the lonely and the unloved, and all in any kind of need. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for all who have died, especially in the pandemic, remembering especially all whom we have known and loved, and all former members and benefactors of our college. May they all rest in peace and rise in glory. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray to Mary, the Mother of God.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Let us pray in silence.
Heavenly Father, all we have and all we are is your gift to us. Give us the grace to know and to do your will. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, that will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sins. Let us pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his saints.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with these offerings, so that purified by your grace, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In the same way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. May this meaning, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and from every evil. Keep me faithful to your teaching, and never let me be parted from you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, you restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ. Increase within us, we pray, the fruits of this sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.